Next, we have adjustment of fixed assets. Fixed assets, you know what are fixed assets. The most important adjustment for fixed asset is depreciation. Already we discussed depreciation is the decrease in the value of an asset due to its usage. So, asset is basically representing your capital expenditure. So, when you use, there will be decrease in the value. That means the value or the resource has expired. So, whenever the resource expires, we call it as expense. So, depreciation is an example of an expense. So, therefore, the rule of nominal account we apply and debit depreciation. So, depreciation account debit to asset account. Why we are crediting asset account? Because we have to remove this amount which has expired from the asset account. Assets show debit balance. So, you have to reduce the amount of debit from that asset. The debit value of the asset has to be reduced. So, we credit the asset. Now, this is the adjustment entry for your depreciation. Now, moving on to the next one, the adjustments related to debtors. The adjustments related to debtors are basically two types. One is that, so we have the first one, when we said related to debtors, we take the first one as bad debts. Now, what is a bad debt? Already discussed in the initial chapters, bad debt represents the amount which you don't receive from your debtors. Who are debtors? The customers who have purchased goods from you on credit, and on that date, these people have still not given you money. So, among these people, if you identify some customers will not be able to give you money, and there is no reason, or there is no, what you can say, it is a waste of effort to think or put in efforts to recover the money from them, because they will not be in a position to pay, or they have disappeared from your place or city completely and tracing them is not possible. As a result, the amounts which you have lost because the customers cannot be traced or they cannot pay, we call them as bad debt. So, here you can say bad debt is representing a loss. So, the rule of nominal account, debit all expenses and losses, we apply to the bad debt and write journal entry for this as bad debts account debit. Now, what is that? Their customers were showing debit balance and you are not going to get. So, remove the amount from them by crediting their account. So, to debtors account. This is the first entry. Then we also have something called provision for doubtful debts. Provision for doubtful debts. Now, this provision for doubtful debts is based on the concept called, or principle called, principle of conservatism. Provision for doubtful debts is the adjustment which you do based on the principle of conservatism. Now, what is principle of conservatism as discussed earlier? It means that if you anticipate such losses, it's not that this year only there will be bad debts, maybe next year also there will be bad debts. So, you can anticipate. So, when you anticipate there will be a loss, so it states that then provide some amount for such expense. Now, what is the meaning of provide some amount for such loss or expense? For example, you make profit, you make a gross profit. So, from gross profit or net profit, set aside some amount so that in future the impact of this loss will be minimized in the business activities. So, that is what we mean by making a provision. So, the journal entry for making a provision for doubtful debts is, the entry is, you have to set aside the profit. So, we debit P&L account. So, P&L account debit to provision for bad or doubtful debts, whatever may be, you can write for provision for bad or doubtful debts account. So, as a result, this amount will appear in P&L debit. And also, if you see, provision for bad and doubtful debts being credited, it can be shown in balance sheet liability. Alternatively, the general procedure or the tradition has been, we minus it from debtors. we minus it from debtors in balance sheet. That you will see explanations later, the shortcuts, etc. So this is how we do the adjustment entries for your debtors. Then coming to the next adjustments related to capital and drawings, the most important being interest on capital. So when we say interest on capital, it is based on the concept, has the businessman not invested money in the business, he would have deposited elsewhere the money, and this money would have fetched some interest for him. So based on this concept, we have this interest on capital. So when businessman is expecting, is only in theory. Now, in businessman is expecting some interest for the money which he has given to business, then from business point of view, it becomes an expense. And you know the rule, all expenses have to be debited. So for interest on capital, our journal entry would be interest on capital account debit to capital account. Why we are crediting capital? Because ultimately this interest has to be given to the owner, and owner's interest is what? Capital. Now, next is interest on drawings. Now, interest on drawings, this is to discourage the owner from taking repeatedly the amounts of business for his personal use. As a result, as he is expecting some interest on what money he has given to business, similarly, the concepts say that business has to expect some money from businessman for the resources what he has been frequently reducing. It is only in theory and based on principle of prudence, etc. Now, so whenever it is interest on drawings, the journal entry would be capital account debit. So, interest on drawings the entry would be capital account debit to interest on drawings account. Now, if you see capital account is getting debited, it means this amount of interest on drawings should be deducted from capital. The amount should be deducted from capital. Okay, interest on drawings should be deducted from capital, and this interest on drawings is like an income for the business. So, since we are crediting, it's a nominal account and it is representing income, ultimately it will go to P&L account credit side. So, this is how the treatment is for interest on drawings. And there are many things that are others. They are usually transactions which are not recorded, or some minor errors which you can easily rectify by debiting or crediting the concerned accounts. Okay, so with this we have completed the discussion about adjustments related to various items. We will be moving on for solving of problems based on trading P&L and balance sheet simultaneously.